Use the snowstorm to mask your approach. Having second thoughts?
Hardly. But I'll have to approach this carefully.
Go on then. I'll keep watch from here.
I can hide in that cart.
What's in the wagon? I need a full inventory.
As you wish. Let's see. 2 barrels of salt, 12 pounds pork, 10 pounds beef, 7 dozen eggs, 16 wheels of cheese. None of it French, don't worry. 5 bottles of whiskey, a couple dozen new uniforms, boots, and leather for patching, blankets, a cart feed for the horses. What else? That's it. That's all there is.
Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
What reason did he give?
He said a diplomatic solution was no solution at all. That allowing the French to retreat would only delay an inevitable conflict, one in which they'd now have the upper hand.
There's merit to those words, as much as I hate to admit it.
Still, can't he see this is unwise?
It doesn't take long. We'll pass them home with our forces divided. Worse, I fear Braddock's bloodlust makes him careless. It puts the men at risk. I'd rather not be delivering grim news to mothers and widows because the bulldog wanted to prove a point.
Where is the general now? Rather than the troops. And then it's on the fort with Cain, I assume? Then
this will be ended soon.
I tried, Josh. I know, my friend. I know.
That map will surely be of use. I need to find it.
Thank you.
Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
What news?
Braddock has left to rally his troops. They're marching on Fort Duquesne. It'll be a while yet till they're ready. which gives us time to form a plan.
No need. We will ambush him here near the river. Go and gather your allies. I will do the same. I will send word when it is time to strike.
A cold, cold round.
Hear, hear.
Hard at work, I see.
How did you...
It is time. We've set up camp to the north. Meet me there.
Gentlemen. Let us away.
First it was too cold. Now it's too goddamn hot.
And humid, too. It's a right swamp, I tell you.
To say nothing of the mosquitoes.
Warm weather and bugs are soon to be the least of our worries.
What? You mean the bulldog? Please. We'll be in that one's beef soon enough and on to the next.
Where's your boy Lee gone off to?
Returned to finish out his service under Braddock.
I imagine the bulldog's none too pleased after the stunt we pulled.
These to spin a tale of my incompetence and beg forgiveness. He has a way with words, especially when it comes to flattery. I expect he'll be welcomed back with open arms.
Which would give us a man inside.
Precisely.
Unless you've underestimated our enemy.
If I have, Charles will sense it first and make his escape. He's more clever than you think.
When this is done, I'm taking a week in New York. It's high time I went and saw the sight.
Of empty whiskey bottles and women's breeches, no doubt.
What other kinds of sights is worth seeing?
I see you've been busy.
All these men are from many different tribes, united in their desire to see Braddock sent away. The Abenaki, the Lenape, the Shawnee.
And you? Who do you stand for?
Myself.
What would you have me do?
Will you help the others to prepare? Follow. They come.
Everything all right, sir?
Just savoring the moment. No doubt, many wonder why it is we've pushed so far west. These are wild lands, as yet untamed and unsettled. But it shall not always be so. In time, our holdings will no longer suffice. And that day is closer than you think. We must ensure our people have ample room to grow and further prosper, which means we need more land. The French understand this and endeavor to prevent such growth. They skirt around our territory, erecting forts and forging alliances, awaiting the day they might strangle us with the noose they've built. This must not come to pass. We must sever the cord and send them back. This is why we ride, to offer them one last chance. The French will leave, or they will die.
Now's the time to strike.
Wait. To scatter the expedition is not enough. We must ensure that Braddock falls, else he's sure to try again. I'll disguise myself as one of his own and make my way to his side. Your ambush will provide the perfect cover for me to deliver the killing blow.
We await your signal.
There, in front of us.
Kill them!
I'm telling you, we've packed the cart too high.
It's all mud.
The ground is uneven,
it's
dangerous, hidden. One false move and the whole thing is sure to fall over.
Panther, you mean?
Sir?
You are grateful to have served.
Edward. Not so fun on the other end of the barrel, is it?
Look out!
Sir.
Where are you off to, Edward?
I never took you for a coward, Edward.
Come on, then! Such arrogance. I always knew it would be the end of you. Is the end of you.
Don't. Hurry before he gets away. I said go!
I don't deserve this! You're a hypocrite, Hatham!
I'm sorry, Edward, but you forced...
Why, Hatham?
Your death opens a door. It's nothing personal. Well, maybe it is a little personal. Been a pain in my ass, after all.
But we are brothers in arms.
Once, perhaps. No longer. Do you think I've forgotten what you did? All those innocents slaughtered, and for what? Does not engender peace to cut your way to resolution.
Wrong. Whether we applied the sword more liberally and more often, the world would be a better place than it is today.
In this instance, I concur. Farewell, Edward.